अवतार मेहर बाबा की जय। मेहरा जहांगीर ईरानी, January 7, 1907 to May 20, 1989. She was Meher Baba's closest mandali, disciple. Meher Baba said she was the purest soul in the universe and that she loved him as he thought to be loved. He called her his Radha and said, "She is my very breath, without which I cannot live." Her accounts of her life with Meher Baba are exhaustively and carefully documented in the 3-volume chronicle Mehra Meher, a Divine Romance, written by David Fenster, based on the tape recordings of Mehra he made. Mehra met Meher Baba for the first time on October 15, 1922. At the age of 15, in the Sakuri ashram of Upasni Maharaj, during a visit with her mother, but did not come to stay with Baba permanently at Mehrabad until 1924. Unique among Meher Baba's women mandali, Mehra was sequestered by Baba from contact with men. It was not until the late 1960s that Mehra J. ईरानी was permitted by Meher Baba to come out of her seclusion and meet some of the men Andali from a distance. On the porch at Mehrazad, she simply folded her hands to them out of respect to their love for Baba and saluted them with Jai Baba. Mehra was one of 4 women who accompanied Baba in his new life period from 1949 to 1951. In 1952, Mehra suffered a severe head injury in an automobile accident with Meher Baba near Prague, Oklahoma. In accordance with Meher Baba's directive, Mehra's final resting place is by his side, adjacent to his samadhi. Although Mehra was born in January from 1968, her birthday has been celebrated on December 22nd. As it was in 1968, in accordance with the Zoroastrian calendar, that being the last year, it was celebrated in Meher Baba's physical presence.
दीननाथ दीन बंधु नाम धरा यो कैसे मैं तो तेरो दास प्रभु
Jai Baba. This program is being done to remember beloved Mehra. Actually, her anniversary was 20th May, but this program is coming to you a few days after that. ये जो program है वो हमारे प्रियतम मेहरा के यादगार में है. वो तो तारीख 20 मई थी, लेकिन ये प्रोग्राम आपको 2-3 दिन बाद आ रहा है. जब से मैं बाबा के कांटेक्ट में आया था, तो एक चीज़ हमको बताई गई थी कि बाबा ने मेहरा को कंप्लीट सेक्युलरिज्म में रखा था और कोई भी आदमी उनके पास नहीं या बात नहीं कर सकता था. Since I came to know about beloved Baba, I had learned that Baba had kept Mehra in total seclusion and she was not allowed to talk to any man or even listen to his voice also many times. That is why whenever we approach Mehra after 1969, our natural instinct was not to go too near to her and not to talk to him. So 1969 ke baad mein jab bhi hum Mehra pe we can't contact me aaye to humko ek dar lagta tha aisa ki Mehra ke nazdeek nahi jana, Mehra se zyada baat nahi karna. To aisi to meri Mehra se directly baat bahut kam ho gayi thi. My personal contact with Mehra was very little, but couple of incidences which I remember, we show how deeply Mehra loved Baba and also Mehra loved others also. This was something unique to me. The first, this, of course, these stories I have narrated before also. The first experience was on 1st February 1969, after we heard that beloved Baba has dropped his body. In those days in Bombay, we did not telephone, so we had no way of contacting other Baba lovers. So myself, my wife and my mother-in-law Dina Talati, we took a night bus from Bombay and arrived at Ahmednagar at about 4:30 in the morning. जब भी हमको बाबा ने शरीर त्याग देने का पता चल गया बम्बई में 31 जनवरी 1969 को, तो उस ज़माने में टेलीफोन नहीं थे, मोबाइल नहीं थे, तो दूसरे लोगों को कांटेक्ट करने का हमको कुछ मौका नहीं था और हम दूर रहते थे. तो मैं, मेरी पत्नी और मेरी मदर इन लॉ दीना तलाटी, वी डिसाइडेड कि हमने लगा रात की बस पकड़ के हम अहमदनगर पहुंच गए. करीबन 4:30-5 बजे हम नगर में आ गए. बॉम्बे डजंट हैव एनी विंटर. समटाइम्स ओवर वन आवर डेज दे हैव, देयर इज सम कोल्ड वेव, अदरवाइज यू डोंट नीड एनी वार्म क्लोथ्स. सो वी डिड नॉट हैव एनी वेरी लाइट वार्म क्लोथ्स वी हैड. And when we landed in Ahmednagar, it was bitterly cold. And we took a tonga, horse carriage, from ST stand. In those horse carriages, two persons had to sit at the back and the third person had to sit with the driver in front. Aur to bahut, it was very cold, utterly cold. Wo zamane mein Bombay mein jyada thandi nahi rehti thi, kabhi kabhi ek do din kabhi thandi ke layer aati thi, to hamare paas jyada woolen kapde nahi rehte the. To ek chote kuch light ka woolen kapde leke hum aaye the aur yahan bahut thandi thi jab hi hum Ahmednagar stand pe utre. To aur humko us zamane mein Mehrabad aane ke liye ye ghode ka tanga yahi tha aur tange mein do log piche baithte the aur ek तीसरे आदमी को आगे ड्राइवर के पास बैठना पड़ता था. तो मैं आगे बैठा था, मेरी पत्नी और मेरी मदर इन लॉ पीछे बैठे थे दोनों, परवीज और दीना, दे वर सिटिंग एट द बैक. एज वी लेफ्ट द एसटी स्टैंड, वेंट लिटिल फर्दर, सडनली आई सॉ कार कमिंग फ्रॉम बिहाइंड. इन दोज डेज इन अहमदनगर देर वेरी फ्यू कार्स. And that car overtook our tanga and went further and suddenly stopped. मैं देख रहा था कि जब भी हमारे एसटी स्टैंड से टांगा निकला हमारा, थोड़ी देर के बाद पीछे से एक कार आ गई. उस ज़माने में मेरा बात अहमदनगर में बहुत कम मोटर व्हीकल्स थे, तो ये कार आके हमारे टांगे को ओवरटेक करके आगे जाके ठहर गई. और मैं देखने लगा, वो जैसी कार ठहरी तो टांगे वाले ने भी टांगा रुका दिया, और रास्ता छोटा था उस ज़माने में. तो मैं देखने लगा कि कौन था, तो मैंने एक देखा, एक वन वूमन गॉट डाउन फ्रॉम द कार, एक स्त्री गाड़ी में से नीचे उतरी. जब भी मैंने देखा तो मुझे लगा कि ये बाबा की सिस्टर मणि है करके. व्हेन आई सॉ, आई थॉट शी इज़ बाबा सिस्टर मणि, बिकॉज अ मंथ बिफोर On 22nd December 1968, when we had come to Mehrazad for Mehra's birthday celebration and Dara Amrit's wedding, I had seen Mani first time at that time. So मैंने मणि को 22 दिसंबर 1968 में जब दारा अमृत की वेडिंग और मेरा माई के बर्थडे के लिए हम मेहराजा आए थे, तभी हमने मैंने मणि को पहले दफे देखा था. तो मैंने मणि को देखा और मैंने तो मैं झटके से टांगे में उतर गया और आगे गया कि ये क्यों खड़ी है रास्ते में. तो मणि बोली मुझे कि मेहरा ने देखा कि दीना पीछे बैठी है टांगे में, उसको बहुत ठंडी लग रही है. तो मेहरा बोलती है कि दीना को हमारे साथ गाड़ी में भेज दो और आप दोनों टांगे में आ जाओ. सो व्हेन आई अप्रोच मणि, मणि टोल्ड मी मेहरा सॉ दीना सिटिंग एट द बैक एंड शी सेज शी इज़ वेरी कोल्ड, शी इज़ नॉट गुड फॉर दीना, सो सेंड दीना इन द कार विथ अस एंड यू एंड परवीज फॉलो इन द टांगा. सो आई वॉज टेकन अबैक. मेहरा वॉज हार्ट ब्रोकन आफ्टर बिलवड बाबाज ड्रॉपिंग हिज बॉडी, बट इवन इन दैट कंडीशन ऑल्सो आई वॉज अमेज दैट शी कुड स्पॉट दीना सिटिंग इन द टांगा फ्रॉम द कार हेडलाइट्स एंड आस्क मणि टू स्टॉप द कार एंड टेक दीना इन द कार. दिस इज समथिंग आई वुड से ओनली अ पर्सन लाइक मेहरा कैन डू, नो बडी एल्स कैन डू. तो यही एक मेहरा की एक चीज थी. और दूसरा एक इंसिडेंट था मेहरा इन 1988 जस्ट बिफोर मेहरा ड्रॉप्ड हिज बॉडी, आई थिंक इन द मंथ इन द इन दिवाली वेकेशन और यस वी हैड कम टू मेहराबाद एंड वी हैड गॉन टू मेहराजाद एंड माई डॉटर वॉज अबाउट 12-13 ईयर्स ओल्ड एट दैट टाइम. एंड व्हाइल टॉकिंग टू मणि, मणि वॉज मेहरा वॉज आस्किंग हर वॉट यू आर डूइंग. सो शी सेड मेहरा आई एम स्टडिंग ऑल्सो एंड आई एम लर्निंग इंडियन क्लासिकल डांसिंग ऑल्सो. सो मेहरा सेज दैट सो सो यू मस्ट डांस ऑन माई बर्थडे प्रोग्राम. मेहरा बर्थडे वॉज सेलिब्रेटेड ऑन 22nd डिसंबर. सो यू से यू मस्ट डांस इन माई बर्थडे प्रोग्राम. So Mani says, Mehra, I don't, that's a very short time. I don't have time to prepare. So instead of this year, I will dance in next year's program. I will get 1 year to prepare. I will prepare some good dance. Mehra says, no, you must dance only this year. And not only she did that, she immediately called Casey Cook and told her, put this little girl's dance in my birthday program, in something like that. जब भी हम दिवाली का मेरे तो दिवाली की छुट्टियों में हम आए थे यहाँ पे, तो मेरी बेटी जब 13 साल की थी और वो मेरा के पास बात करते करते उन्होंने उनको बताया होगा कि मैं अभी स्कूल में इंडियन क्लासिकल डांस भी सीख रही हूँ. तो मेरा ने उसको बोला कि ये मेरे बर्थडे प्रोग्राम होगा अभी 22 दिसंबर को, उसमें तुझे डांस करना है. तो उसने बोला, मेरा ये तो बहुत शॉर्ट टाइम है, अगले साल करूँगी, मैं थोड़ा प्रिपेयर करूँगी अच्छे तरह से, अभी तो मैं डांस सीख रही हूँ. तो मेहरा ने बोला, कुछ नहीं है, तुमको यही साल डांस करना है. इतना ही नहीं, उन्होंने केसी कुक को बुलाया और बोला कि ये लड़की का डांस तुम मेरे इस पर रख दे. देन केसी अरेंज 2 or 3 अदर गर्ल्स टुगेदर इन सम स्किट दे वर परफॉर्मिंग, दे इंट्रोड्यूस अ डांस एंड दे हैड अ 3 or 4 मिनट्स डांस. Little did we realize that that will last birthday celebration in Mehra's presence in Mehrabad, because in May 1989 she dropped her body. So how come she insisted that Mani should dance in that year only and not next year? This was something very unique, I would say. These are some of the experiences of the love and kindness which Mehra bestowed on everybody. One thing is there, as far as I know, Mehra did not like to be called in any name other than Mehra. Mehra ko Mehra Mai aisa bolna pasand nahi tha. Wo hamesha bolti thi sabko, hum Bombay walon ko zarur bolti thi ki mujhe Mehra karke pukaro, dusre koi naam se mat pukaro. So these are our reminiscences of beloved Mehra. And she was a unique person. How Baba would say, हाउ आई शुड बी लव्ड, यू शुड लर्न फ्रॉम मेहरा। बाबा हमेशा बोलते थे मुझे प्यार कैसा करना है आप मेहरा से सीखो, जैसा मेहरा मुझे प्यार करती है वैसा मुझे प्यार करो। और मेहरा के जीवन में बाबा के अलावा कुछ नहीं था, सिर्फ बाबा बाबा ही थे। उन्होंने बड़ी छोटी उम्र से सबका त्याग करके बाबा को फॉलो किया और ये बहुत कठिन परिस्थिति। मेहरा वॉज ब्रॉट अप इन ए वेरी गुड फैमिली, वेल्दी फैमिली, शी वॉज गोइंग टू गुड स्कूल एंड सडनली शी हैड टू लीव एवरीथिंग एंड जॉइन बाबाज आश्रम एंड लीव ए सिंपल लाइफ, नॉट ओनली सिंपल लाइफ टोटली सेक्लूडेड लाइफ एंड टोटली डिवोटेड टू बाबा। एंड दिस वॉज ओनली मेहरा कुड डू, नो बडी एल्स कैन डू। सो जय बाबा।
अवतार मेहर बाबा की जय। नमो हे परब्रह्म रूपा मेहे, नमो हे परम देव देवा नमो हे परम धर्म मूलम मे हे, नमो हे परम ज्ञान शक्ति मे हे, नमो हे पिता मातृ भ्राता नमो हे सखा स्वामी दाता मे हे, नमो स्फूर्ति दाता विधाता मे हे, नमो स्फूर्ति दाता विधाता नमो आत्म आराध्य देवा मेह। मेहर एकम मेहर नित्यम मेहर सत्यम सुंदरम, मेहर एकम मेहर नित्यम मेहर सत्यम सुंदरम, मेहर स्वामी सकल धामी, मेहर स्वामी सकल धामी, तुम नमामि मेहरम। आ मेहर एकम मेहर नित्यम मेहर सत्यम सुंदरम, विश्वकर्ता सकल त्राता दुरित हरता मेहरम, विश्वकर्ता सकल त्राता दुरित हरता मेहरम, पूर्ण शक्ति प्रेम मूर्ति पूर्ण शक्ति प्रेम मूर्ति, दिव्य शांति सागरम। आ मेहर एकम मेहर नित्यम मेहर सत्यम सुंदरम।
Remembering Mera is so easy because everything about her was unforgettable. The way her beauty, Mera's beauty, Mera's grace, Mera's kindness, and most of all, the radiance of his love for her, which shone from around her presence like the sun. If you met her, you could not avoid remembering him. She was the most remarkable human being I have ever met in my life, other than within my heart meeting Meher Baba. The first time I met Mera was at Guru Prasad in 1969 in April at the last darshan. In the group that I had come with, she had decided to meet the men. In the previous group, she had not met the men. But in this second group, she had decided to meet the men. And we were instructed to file in through a doorway into the side of Guru Prasad from the main hall, where she would be standing in a door, in a doorway, with her hands folded. And when we approached her to face her and just say Jai Baba, and she would say Jai Baba to us, and then pass on out onto the veranda and come back around to the hall at Guru Prasad. For me, this is one of the most unforgettable moments in my entire life. I'd turned 21 the day before I left for Darshan in 69. So I was a kid. And as I stepped, the whole Darshan program had been overwhelming already. And as I stepped from the hall into that, through that doorway to approach Mara, I saw this figure standing in the doorway, and I folded my hands and faced her. And as I looked into her eyes, I realized that there was a depth within this being, this woman, this being, that was infinite. I could fall into her being forever, and there would be no end. She was limitless. And I came away, and she said, Jai Baba, and I said, Jai Baba, and I walked away, and for about 2 hours, I was a little bit dazed from the experience of the magnitude of who this person was for the first time. And when I left after Darshan, I thought I would never see her again, because I had heard of Baba in 67, and he'd been in seclusion, and we couldn't come, and we couldn't come until he gave the invitation for the Darshan in 69. So I thought, now that Baba's dropped the body, I will never see Mara again, because when will that invitation come? And I would remember her over and over in my life, as I was in my life at that time, different moments. I was doing farm labor on my grandfather's farm, and I would remember her in the fields, and I would be acting in plays and directing plays and teaching school, and I would be remembering her and thinking, when will I see her? And then in 1972, I heard that people were coming on pilgrimage, which I didn't know. I hadn't known that up till, because I lived in Colorado and didn't have contact with other Baba lovers. And there wasn't the internet then. So anyway, I heard people were coming on pilgrimage to India, and I thought, I've got to go. So in 73, I came back for the first time after 69 on pilgrimage. And much of how our beloved expresses his love for us is always miraculous and fantastic and overwhelming and ultimately to be desired. And so he made that trip so worthwhile in every single respect. But one of the greatest high points of the trip was the time I would spend with Mara, and how she would let me be with the women and with her on the veranda, and how Gohar would encourage me to take sherbet from the kitchen in the house and come out and serve Mara, to have that contact with Mara. And my life ever after, till Mara died, was involved with, much of my life was involved with the joy of having the radiance of her presence in whatever we did. Avatar Mera Baba Ki Jai.
अवतार मेहर बाबा की जय प्रेम अवतार मेहर बाबा की जय
मौन अवतार मेहर बाबा की
जय
जन्म की दे सद्बाटा कैवल्य मुंदे बाटा मोक्षार्हम मानव जन्म चेय कुमावृधा चेय कुमावृधा
जन्म की दे सद्बाटा कैवल्य मुंदे बाटा मोक्षारंभो मानव जन्म चेय कुमावृधा चेय कुमावृधा
परब्रह्म परमात्मा मेहर बाबा रूपम दाची
परब्रह्म परमात्मा मेहर बाबा रूपम दाची
सृष्टि विनाश अवसान कालमुन प्रेम बीजमुन नाचो
सृष्टि विनाश अवसान कालमुन प्रेम बीजमुन नाटे
जय जय लो जय जय लो जगदीश्वर्ण को जय जय लो
जय जय लो जय जय लो जगदीश
मोर पावन मौनी जन्म
अंजलि मोची अर्पिंचूरा पावन मौनी जन्म चेय कुमावृता चेय कुमावृता की जन्म दिने सत्पाटा कैवल्य मुंदे बाटा मोक्षारंभ मानव जन्म चेय कुमावृता चेय कुमावृता
स्वमतमुलनु विडनाडे अभिमतमेमियुलेदु
स्वमतमुलनु विडनाडे अभिमतमेमियुलेदु
आया मतमुल निज धर्ममुलनु आचरिंचुचुंडु
आया मतमुल निज धर्ममुलनु आचरिंचुचुंडु
जय जय लो जय जय लो जगदीश्वरुनकु जय जय लो
जय जय लो जय जय लो जगदीश्वरुनकु जय जय लो
अंजलि मोर्चि अर्पिंचुमुर पावन मौनी जन्म
अंजलि मोर्चि अर्पिंचुमुर पावन मौनी जन्म
चेय कुमावृता
चेय कुमावृता ई जन्म कि दे सत्पाटा कैवल्य मुंदे पाटा मोक्षारंभ मानव जन्म चेय कुमावृता चेय कुमावृता
स्वार्थ रहित मौ सेवा दैनंदिन स्वकीय धर्मम
स्वार्थ रहित मौ सेवा दैनंदिन स्वकीय धर्मम
निष्काम सेवा मनसार प्रेम तो आचरिंचुचुंडु
निष्काम सेवा मनसार प्रेम तो आचरिंचुचुंडु
जय जय लो जय जय लो जगदीश्वरुनकु जय जय लो
जय जय लो जय जय लो जगदीश्वरुनकु जय जय लो
अंजलि मोर्चि अर्पिंचुमुर पावन मौनी जन्म
अंजलि मोर्चि अर्पिंचुमुर पावन मौनी जन्म जय कुमावृता जय कुमावृता ई जन्म कि दे सत्पाटा कैवल्य मुंदे बाटा मोक्षारंभ मानव जन्म जय कुमावृता जय कुमावृता
बाबा बाबा यनुचु पदुनालगु सालु प्रतिदिनमु
बाबा बाबा यनुचु पदुनालगु सालु प्रतिदिनमु
निर्मल चित्तुडवै प्रभु नामम संस्मरिंचुचुंडु
निर्मल चित्तुडवै प्रभु नामम संस्मरिंचुचुंडु
जय जय लो जय जय लो जगदीश्वरुनकु जय जय लो
जय जय लो जय जय लो जगदीश्वरुनकु जय जय लो
अंजलि मोर्चि अर्पिंचुमुर पावन मौनी जन्म
अंजलि मोर्चि अर्पिंचुमुर पावन मौनी जन्म चेय कुमावृता चेय कुमावृता कैवल्य मुंदे पाटा मोक्षारंभ मानव जन्म चेय कुमावृता चेय कुमावृता
श्री मेहर बाबा पिलुकु गोपाल केल्ल मेल कुंतु
श्री मेहर बाबा पिलुकु गोपाल केल्ल मेल कुलुकु
తరుణమిదే విడనాడ కోయి అవకాశం
సమయము మించే తరుణమిదే విడనాడ కోయి అవకాశం
సమయము మించే తరుణమిదే విడనాడ కోయి అవకాశం
సమయము మించే తరుణమిదే విడనాడ కోయి అవకాశం
జే జే లో జే జే లో జగదీశ్వరుడు
జయ జయ లో జయ
ಕೈವಲ್ಯ ಮುಂದೆ ಪಾಠ ಮೋಕ್ಷಾರಂಭ ಮಾನವ ಜನ್ಮ ಜಯ ಕುಮಾರುಧ ಜಯ ಕುಮಾರುಧ
ಜಯ ಕುಮಾರುಧ ಜಯ ಕುಮಾರುಧ
Jai Baba. I had the good fortune to live at Mehrazad when I was very new here. It was 1983 or 84, I think. So I was very new. I was very ignorant and very full of myself. And I did not understand really who Mehra was. Of course, I was always happy to be in her company, but there were so many things I didn't understand. And of course, the house at Mehrazad, everything revolved around Mehra. Everything was when Mehra is ready. And I would sometimes allow my mind to say, why do we wait? You know, why is Mehra not on time? Why do we have to wait for her? And once something happened that really surprised me and impressed me. So that was on Baba's birthday. So it is 5 o'clock in the morning, 25th February. Everybody is in Baba's room, all the ladies. And after the prayers, after the singing, every one by one, the ladies would bow down to Baba's bed. And there was a set order, you know, first Mehra, then Mani, Gohar, Rano. And of course, I was last. And, you know, they took some time. So while Mehra would start, everybody else would sit down, and everybody at their place would sit. So the singing is finished, I sit down, and I notice that the cook, Jaya, is not sitting down. And usually the cook was not part of morning aarti. She lived in Mehrazad, but usually aarti was like around 10 o'clock. And by then, of course, the cook was busy in the kitchen. So she's not sitting like everybody else. And the next thing I know, Mehra is moving. Mehra is not going to Baba's bed. Mehra is going across the room. And with one foot, she's pushing the little piece of carpet that is in front of her chair for her feet, because she has noticed and she has understood that Jaya is not sitting down because there is nothing for her to sit down on. You know, Baba did not want the ladies to sit directly on the Farsi, it is called. So she had nothing to sit on, so she was remaining standing. And Mehra herself brought to the servant that piece of carpet that she could sit. And it totally blew my mind, you know, that she is the queen, but she's ready, totally naturally, she does this kind of service with total humility. And after that, you know, my mind kept quiet, that we can wait for Mehra to be ready. She's a very special kind of queen. Jai Baba.
Jai Baba. We are about to perform the song Muraliya De Do Radha Pyari. Around 44 years ago, Mehra Mai called my grandmother Sunita Lakshmikant Thade and gave her a recording of this song and asked her to choreograph a dance. Mehra told Sunita that beloved Baba loved this song, and so, sung by Sunita Thade and Narendra Thade, a dance was performed by Alka Thade Padmavar as Radha and K.C. Cook as Krishna at Mehrazad in 1976.
Thank you. Hello there. My name is Paul Burchard. In the summer of 1973, I made my first visit to India, to Mehrabad and Meherazad and Ahmednagar. During that time, probably in the month of August, Alaba, Ali Akbar Shapurzaman, took it into his mind and heart to teach me by phonetic drilling several lines of Farsi and then a couplet of Hafez in order to recite these for Mehra on the other side of the compound at Meherazad. And after three or four sessions, we did that. And I went around and recited the following lines to Mehra in Farsi as coached by Alaba. And I'll translate them at the end. Mer Baba Pawardigare Alam Ast Ma Muridan Ishan Hastim Ma Baroye Zirate Mer Baba Bemerabad Vamerzad Rafta Budim Chat Mesukut Vazuhure Mer Baba Dar Alam Chelin Nazdik Ast Sao Keninne Eolaute Motehide Amrika Sao Dat Mandant Ke inkhadar meher babara dust midarand. That is to say, Meher Baba is the Parvardigar of the universe. We are his disciples. We have come to visit his ziyarat, his places of pilgrimage at Mehrabad and Meherazad. The time of Meher Baba's breaking of his silence and his manifestation to the universe is not far off. And finally, the people of the United States of America are so fortunate because they love Meher Baba so much. And finally, the couplet of Hafez. Az kimi yohye mehreto, zargasht ruyeman, ari, beyomne lotfe shoma, hak zarshavat. Which is to say, by the alchemy of your love, my face has turned to gold. Yes, by your compassion, dust turns to gold. As I say, I recited these lines for Mehra, and I'm happy to remember them now as we remember Baba's beloved, Mehra. Thank you, and Jai Baba.
मन की ध्यान से राधे रानी लंबी दौड़ लगाए गोकुल से मथुरा जाए जाए दर्श कर आए लौटाने पर सावरिया को प्रेम की बंसी सुनाए एक दिन राधा रानी से ओ एक दिन राधा रानी से रूठ गए गिरधारी रूठ गए गिरधारी राधा मना मना कर हारी राधा मना मना कर हारी एक दिन
चुपके से
बंसी चुरा के
फिर चुपके से बंसी चुरा के
राधा ने होठों से लगा के
राधा ने होठों से लगा के
गाया ऐसा लगे झूमने
लगे झूमने लगे झूमने
लगी झूमने दुनिया सारी
लगी झूमने दुनिया सारी राधा रानी से हो एक दिन राधा रानी से रूठ गए गिरधारी
को लेकर नारे ऐसा गीत सुनाओ रे
ऐसा गीत सुनाओ रे मन बंसी को लेकर प्यारे ऐसा गीत सुनाओ
लगन लगाओ रे
मन भाव रे ओ मन भाव रे हरि से लगन लगाओ रे प्रभु से लगन लगाओ रे
हरि नाम मुरलिया प्रीत भरी अमर शांति संगीत
संगीत भरी
हरि ओम हरि 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 हरि ओम हरि
May God bless and keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for others and let others do for you. And may you build a ladder to the stars, and may you climb on every rung, and may you stay. Forever young. Forever young. Forever young. And may you stay. Forever young. And may you grow up to be righteous. May you grow up to be true. May you always know the truth and see the light surrounding you. And may you always be courageous. Stand upright and be strong, and may you stay forever young. May your hands always be busy. May your feet always be swift. May you have a strong foundation when the winds of changes shift. May your heart always be joyful. May your song always be sung. And may you stay forever young. Forever young. Forever young. And may you stay forever young.
Jay Baba. I wrote this song in 1989, A Pilgrim's Artie.
Thank you. Avtaar Meher Baba Ki Jai. On May 24, 1952, near the small town of Prague, Oklahoma, Avtaar Meher Baba shed his blood on American soil. With him and sharing in his sacrifice were some of his closest disciples, including his cherished and most beloved Mehra. On May 21st, Meher Baba and some of his mandali started their travel from Myrtle Beach to Meher Mount, California. May 23rd, Baba and his mandali spent night in a motel. Next morning, May 24th, Baba and his mandali arose early as usual. Baba sent Sarosh and the Western woman out to eat while he stayed with Mehra, Mehru, Mani and Goher. Elizabeth was driving car in which Baba sat in front. Seated behind were Mehra, Mehru and Mani. Following them was a station wagon driven by Sarosh with Goher, Kitty, Delia and Ranu. After breakfast, the group stood waiting in front of the motel for Baba's signal to get into the cars. But Baba delayed the start, standing for a long time on his doorstep. Kitty remembers he was sad, withdrawn and unusually still. There were no last minute questions, no hurry to be off. Finally, after 10 minutes, he walked to the car with the Eastern woman. They had driven only a short distance when Baba had Elizabeth stop the car. He got out and paced up and down the right side of the road without explanation. Delia de Leon remembered. He seemed very depressed and haggard. He walked ahead with his head bent, seeming very far away. Later, Sarosh and his passengers stopped in a small town for coffee and cokes. We then put on speed to meet Baba at the appointed place, Delia recalled. We could see no sign of his car and were beginning to get worried. It was about 10:05 a.m. We heard an exclamation of alarm from Sarosh. We turned our heads to the right. At first, we could not take in what happened. We could not see clearly from the car. We saw people standing around Baba, who seemed to be lying on the ground. The women were lying in various directions. Sarosh exclaimed, "Oh God, there's been an accident." With lightning speed, we jumped out of the car and rushed forward. The anguish of that moment is unforgettable Baba's face. With blood pouring from his head, the extraordinary expression on Baba's face. His eyes just staring straight ahead as if into unfathomable distances. He made no sound or sign, just lay there motionless. Elizabeth was in the car, doubled over the wheel. Her first question had been, "Is he alive?" The rain that had made the road so slippery also blessingly made the road's shoulders soft and muddy, cushioning the impact of Baba and the Indian woman. Delia placed pillow beneath Baba's bleeding head. The farmer who was in front of the accident heard the terrible sound of the collision and rushed to assist. He lovingly covered the victims with his own blankets. The first car to pass was that of a man who was taking his wife to Prague Clinic, 7 miles away to have a baby. He summoned a pair of ambulances to the scene. 7 miles east of the accident site, Dr. Ned Wilson was making his rounds at the clinic he had founded and maintained since 1950. The first person brought into the clinic was Elizabeth, who had a broken arm and 11 broken ribs. Mara's injuries were the most critical of all. In 1970, Dr. Wilson said she had suffered the worst skull fracture I've ever seen. Like an egg you have dropped on the floor, he hadn't expected her to live. Of the others in the car with Baba, Mehru's wrists were both broken, while Mani, who had been sleeping at the time of accident, sustained only minor injuries. Dr. Wilson, picking particles of glass out of Mehra's frontal bone when Dr. Goher rushed in and frantically urged him to come and see Baba. They were saying, "Baba this, Baba that." I did not know what they were talking about and barely heard Dr. Irani because of the concentration on what I was doing. When Dr. Wilson finally got around to attending to Baba, he was most surprised. As soon as I came in the doorway, he starts grinning at me and smiling away. So I figured he couldn't be too badly hurt. Till I found later, I was astounded to find that he did not speak or make a sound denoting discomfort. I assumed that he could not, but was soon informed that he did not speak because of the willful act. I knew we were going to have to give him a general anesthesia, set his fractures, and I suspected that he would say something at that time, but he didn't. In a message Baba dictated on June 13th, he said, "The personal disaster for some years foretold by me has at last happened while crossing the American continent, causing me through facial injuries, a broken leg and a broken arm, much mental and physical suffering. It was necessary that it should happen in America. God willed it so." The date of this event was foretold by Baba many years earlier. At Harman on Hudson in 1932, Meher Baba gave Elizabeth Patterson a small pink wildflower and told her to always keep the flower and write down the date that someday she would know the meaning. It wasn't until years after the accident that Elizabeth discovered the flower he had given her that day and written next to it in the Bible the date May 24th, 1932, exactly 20 years to this day that she would be driving the accident vehicle. Meher Baba explained that this American accident and then the one in India 4 years later symbolized his bringing together the West and the East by shattering first the left and then the right side of his body. He said that this cross exchange in his own body would result in benefit to the whole world. He said on other occasions that during this advent, it would be necessary for the avatar to undergo this self-sacrifice. Baba was seriously injured as a result of this event and combined with the more severe injuries sustained in the 1956 automobile accident in India. He was never able to walk without pain again for the rest of his physical life. Jai Baba.
Thank you. sullen, swollen, with a brooding Gallic face, trudges humanity in soul's solemn race, entrapped in past chains, your lovers we promised to be, but with one debacle, we cry and scream, why me? All you asked was not to worry, to constantly love and remember thee, to cheerfully roam the carousel of life, to bear the pain and suffering with glee. But with a mere glimpse of suffering, the foolish mortals we tend to be, often crying and wailing, inevitably making we're just a human plea. So time and again, to forgive our harrowing deed, appearing in human form, you profusely bleed. Perpetually crucified, Lord, how much do you care? All accidents, seclusions, fast you smilingly bear. Hail to you, Lord, and your relentless wish to free mankind and grant liberty. When with a word, all-powerful God, you can annihilate minds and pardon iniquity. Yet you choose to enthrust us, empowering us to be one. Truly, infinitely simple and guileless God, we pray, thy will be done.
सभी उपस्थित बाबा प्रेमियों को मेरा जय बाबा। आज 24 मई लगभग 68 साल के पहले अमेरिका भूमि पर बाबा की बाबा जिस कार में सफ़र कर रहे थे उस कार में बड़ा भयानक ऐसा एक्सीडेंट हुआ, अपघात हुआ। दो कार सामने सामने टकरा गई, उसमें बाबा कार के बाहर फेंके गए, रास्ते के किनारे वो खाई में गिरे, उनकी नाक की हड्डी टूट गई, खून से शरीर लथपथ हो गया और बाएं पैर में फ्रैक्चर हो गया। काफ़ी तकलीफ हो गई बाबा को। वहाँ से फिर ठीक तौर से ट्रीटमेंट करने के बाद बाबा जल्दी से अच्छे हो गए, अच्छी तरह से चलने फिरने लगे थे। और इतना ही नहीं, लेकिन 1953 और 54 दो वर्ष में दो दो बार बाबा ने आंध्रा और हमीरपुर के दो बड़े बड़े दौरे किए और लाखों में बाबा ने लोगों को दर्शन दिया। एक अजीब सी बात थी कि इतने जल्दी के काल में बाबा की तबीयत भी अच्छी तरह से सुधर गई। उसी के बाद कुछ साल बाद 1956 में 2 दिसंबर को बाबा को फिर से दूसरा एक्सीडेंट हुआ। वो सातारे के पास उड़तारे करके गांव नाम का गांव है, उस गांव के पास में बाबा के कार को एक्सीडेंट हुआ। ये एक्सीडेंट इतना भयानक था कि उसका हालांकि कोई कारण नहीं था। एरज भाई ने जब बाद में बताया था कि अचानक से वो स्टीयरिंग व्हील जोर से हिला और एकदम गाड़ी बाजू के पैरापेट वॉल से टकरा गई और खाई के एकदम रास्ते के नीचे उतर कर चली। ये एक्सीडेंट में बाबा को काफ़ी चोटें आई, बाबा की जुबान को कटी गई, फिर बाबा के सीधे पैर के हिप जॉइंट में फ्रैक्चर हो गया। ये जो दूसरे एक्सीडेंट में जो क्षति हो गई बाबा को, वो क्षतियों ने बाबा को आखिरी तक, यानी बाबा ने देह त्याग करने तक बहुत बहुत तकलीफ दी। बाबा ने बहुत बहुत कष्ट सहन के बहुत बहुत दुख सहन किया ये दूसरे एक्सीडेंट के बाद में।
मेरे मन को छूता हर दर्द वो
मन को छूता हर
Thank you. Kalchuri, Baba lover from Ahmednagar. Just I like to talk about Baba's accidental place in Oklahoma. Beloved Baba, he met with the two accident. One was there in US, Oklahoma, near Prague, 1952. And second accident, Baba met in Satara in India in 1956. Previously, just Baba said about this, you know, he will just, you know, shed his blood in India and in America. And according to that, you know, Baba did that, you know, in Prague. Elizabeth Patterson, Margaret and Norina, according to Baba's instruction, they opened the Baba Center in South Carolina, Myrtle Beach Center, and they invited Baba for inauguration of the center. They constructed, according to the Baba's instruction, guest house, meeting hall, then ladies mandali's guest house and other guest house, you know, and it was according to the Baba's instruction they made that. And then they invited Baba, and Baba, he accepted their invitation. And just in April 1952, Baba gave the date, and according to that, you know, they made the arrangement for Baba. And then Baba, he started from Mehrazad, 18th April. Male mandali were also there, Sarosh, Meherji Karkaria, Dr. Nilkant Godse, Adi Kirani Senior, Gustaji, and Baba told them they can just go first to New York from Bombay, and then afterwards, you know, Baba, he will come along with the ladies mandali. And according to that, Baba, Mehra, Mehru, Mani, all these people, Baba and all these people, they went to the Bombay, and from Bombay they flew to the New York. William Donkin, Baba, he sent already to him to Myrtle Beach to see the arrangement, and according to that, William Donkin, he left. Baba just, you know, he reached there in New York on 20th or 21st April in New York, and that day was the Sunday, and because of that, all the restaurants and hotels were closed. Only there was one restaurant, and it was Indian guy's restaurant, and then Baba stayed in that restaurant, Indian guy's restaurant, and then from there, Baba went to the Florence, and from in New York, Elizabeth Patterson and Margaret, they came to receive Baba at airport. And then from there, Baba, along with the ladies mandali, went to the Myrtle Beach. And about 1 month, Baba, he stayed in the Myrtle Beach already. Margaret, Elizabeth, they did all the arrangement for Baba there in the Myrtle Beach Center. Norina also, she met Baba. Norina didn't come to the New York because of her heart trouble. She remains at Myrtle Beach Center. And after that, you know, just they took Baba in the guest house where they met for Baba, and Baba and ladies mandali also. Their ladies mandali's guest house was also there, and then Norina, Margaret, Elizabeth, all they stayed there. James mandali also, they came and they stayed there. When they stayed there, every day Baba used to go to the walk in the morning and evening time also in Myrtle Beach. And there was a two lakes natural lakes were there, that two lakes and the ocean. Then Baba used to go there, and Baba just, he said, just I appreciate this, you know, because this is my heart is open here in Myrtle Beach, you know. And my Elizabeth and Margaret, Norina, they felt very happy. Baba felt also very happy in that way. Then what happened, you know, 9th of May, they did the inauguration. And up to that period, you know, only the particular people, they used to come to Baba. But on 9th, when the inauguration took place, then many people, they started coming, like Darwin Shah, his family, Francis Brabazon also, he attended. He came first time and he met Baba there in Myrtle Beach. After that, Ibidush's daughter, Sarman, all they came, and old time Baba lovers who met Baba in India and in West also, Europe also, all of them, you know, they came, and about 300 people, you know, just they gathered, and they met Baba. Everybody, they felt very happy. Baba asked, you know, Darwin Shah, just he can keep his son for the night watch. And Darwin Shah, he felt very happy, and his son just he came for the night watch in Baba's bedroom. And Baba just gave order to him, just you can go in next bedroom and you can sleep there. But Baba's he said, Baba, if I take rest because I am very tired, and if I go and I lie on the bed, I will get the sleep. Baba said, just my order is there, and don't worry, and just go. And when I will clap, you know, or I will, the buzzer was there, and I will do that, I will buzz that, you know, and you must come. And he said, okay, Baba, but if I go in deep sleep, then it is impossible for me, you know, to wake up, because I'm very tired. That's why it is better I can sit near you. But Baba said, no, it is my order, you can go and lie down. And just he slept in the sound sleep. Baba did not call him, Baba did not clap, or that buzzer also did not do. And what happened in the morning, when he came to Baba, it was difficult for him, you know, to read Baba's gesture and alphabetical board also. Then Baba told to Darwin Shah, just he can go back, you know, and when you come, you know, along with the family, then that time you can bring him. I am very happy with this boy. And then afterwards, one Afro-American boy was brought for the night watch, and same problem arises. Mm-hmm. The boy, just, you know, it was difficult for him to read Baba's gesture and even alphabetical board also. And Baba just told the boy he can also leave. The boy also left. Then Baba kept Mehrjikar Kariya and Dr. Nilkant Godse, you know, for the night watch. For new person, it was very difficult to do that. According to the Agnes, she started Baba's center, Mehr Mount, in California state, and she also invited Baba, and Baba accepted her invitation. And just Baba used to say her Agni. Agni means fire. Mm-hmm. And Baba gave that special name to the Agnes, you know, Agni. And Baba used to say that Agni, fire. That is the Indian, Agni means Indian name, fire. And 18th of May, Baba just remained for 1 month in Myrtle Beach. And then Baba told, just, you know, on 18th May, he will leave for the California state to go to the Mehr Mount. Everything was decided. Baba told Sarosh, Mehrji Karkariya, Adike Irani, Gustaji, and Dr. Nilkant, they can go ahead to the Mehr Mount and just help them in a preparation. William also, Baba told, just he also can go, and he left first. Then Baba started along with the Mehra, Mehru, Mani, Baba Elizabeth, she was driving, you know, for Baba's car, and Baba sat in that car, and another car, Sarosh was driving, and with Sarosh, Dr. Goher and Margaret. Margaret, Delia, Dillon, all these people, they sat in the second car, and Baba gave the instruction to the Sarosh, he can follow Baba's car. And that was Baba's warning also, and Baba's instruction also. And Baba said, if you don't do that, you know, then I will never forgotten you. That's why I always remember that, you know, follow the car. And then they started, you know, like Columbia, North Carolina, then the South Carolina, that Murphy City. And each time Baba halt there, you know, he stayed in the night in restaurant, sometimes in motel, and just, you know, the food, just Baba and Manli members, they were taking there, you know, more time, most of the time Baba did not like the food, but even he was eating that, taking that food. And mostly Baba was vegetarian, and Baba also told the Manli members, you know, they should be vegetarian, but other ladies and that, they were non-vegetarian. And Baba said, whoever eat the non-vegetarian, I never restrict them, you know, because for me vegetarian, non-vegetarian is the same. I don't mind about that, but for my Manli members, you know, the instruction is there, they only consume the vegetarian food. And according to that, you know, all the male Manli, ladies Manli, and Baba also, they were taking the vegetarian food. And according to that, you know, it took 4 days for them, you know, when they started on 18th of May, 4 to 5 days it took, you know, to go to the California state, Oklahoma. And when Baba entered into the Oklahoma state, after that, you know, in Prague, near Prague, you know, there was one guy was driving the car, and it was hilly area. And Elizabeth, she has seen that car, you know, she thought, you know, she took her car in the proper direction, but the guy did not see that car, and just he come forward and he hit the Baba's car, and the accident took place. When the accident took place, you know, Baba just he thrown down from the car, and Mehra, and Mehra also, and Mehru also, just they thrown out from the car, and the accident was really very dangerous. Baba met with that accident. Baba's nose was broken, and then bleeding started. When the bleeding started, Baba's leg also, it was fractured, and Baba's left hand and left leg was fractured. Nobody was there, and the Mehra's forehead, skull was fractured. Mehru's also, she also got injured, but not so seriously. Elizabeth, she was in the car, holding the steering, but her about 12 ribs, you know, were broken. Money was there inside, in back side, but she unhurt. Nothing happened to the money, but these three people just, they fell down out, and when they fell down out, you know, they were lying on the road, and it was very the serious situation. The person just, you know, who was driving the car, his wife and mother was there in the car, but all of three of them, they unhurt, nothing happened to them. But the mother and wife, they came, and they looked after the Mehra and others. There was one deliver man's van was there, deliver boys, and he kept that van. And the guy, he said, you know, because of that van, you know, I could not able to see the car is coming, and because of the accident was made, But Elizabeth, she gave differently, you know, the guy came forward directly and he was in fast speed. Elizabeth Patterson, she controlled the car, but the guy hit the Elizabeth's car and the big accident just took place. Everybody, they were lying there, and Sarosh, just Baba gave the warning to him, you know, he should follow the Baba's car. But what happened, you know, because of the hot weather, all of them, they stopped to take the soft drink, and after 20 minutes they reached there. But before that, one guy, he was taking his pregnant wife to the hospital and in ambulance, and he saw all this scene, you know, and then the help got from him, and then he dropped his wife, and then same ambulance they sent back, and then just Baba and Mehra, Mehru, Elizabeth, all in the ambulance they have taken. And then there was nearby 9 miles there was one hospital, and they took into that hospital. The Dr. Nate and his wife Julia, they were there, and just they started treating Baba. First he started, saw the Mehra, her skull was just fractured totally and it was bleeding. Then first he treated Mehra and Dr. Nilkant, and after that Saroshi came, and just they shocked, they saw Baba's body lying on the road, and Mehra and Mehru, and it was difficult for Gaur what to do, you know. But all of them, they took Baba to the hospital, and just there was no space for Baba, and the doctor, he kept Baba in his office, and other Mehra and others, you know, they kept in a separate room. And then afterwards, just Dr. Kaver and Dr. Nilkant, they came to Dr. Ned, and they told, you know, just you can come and see Baba. But he thought, you know, Mehra is more injured, and that's why he was just giving the treatment to the Mehra. Then afterwards he turned to the Baba. He came and Baba was smiling. That's why doctor, he thought, you know, Baba is not that much serious. That's why he was smiling. He did not know anything, who is Meher Baba and about the Mandli. But just when he observed Baba, and then just he shocked, Baba is more serious than others, you know, because his nose was broken, on face the swelling was there, and his left hand and leg was fractured, seriously fractured. And then afterwards doctor, he plastered Baba's leg, and just Baba's hand also he treated, Baba's nose also just he treated, and just he shocked, you know, Baba, he was smiling, you know, and he was also talking means gesturing to the doctor. And step by step doctor, he got that understanding, you know, about Meher Baba, about his Mandli, and he saw that discipline and that patience, you know, about all the Mandli members, you know. And step by step, you know, he changed. What Baba used to do, you know, Baba used to call through Dr. Gover or Nilkant, to call doctor in the night also, when he used to go to in his bedroom. The Nilu used to call, and doctor used to come, and Baba used to say, you know, just lot of pain is there in leg, and just this plaster is hurting me. And the doctor said to Baba, just okay, then I will remove this plaster. The Baba used to say, no, it is all right. And then after again 5 minutes, Baba used to send Nilkant or other Mandli members, and Baba used to call the doctor, and Baba used to say, you know, it is really very, the pain is there, and the plaster is hurting. And continuously Baba used to call, but doctor, he never felt upset. or he never annoyed, you know. He was happy whenever Baba used to call, he used to come and he used to attend Baba. And according to that, you know, he came close to the Baba, and his wife also, Julia, she also came close to the Baba through that, you know. And about 12 days, Baba stayed there. Doctor, he called the specialist there, you know, for Mera and for Baba also. And then they also did the checkup and that for Baba and Mehra. Mostly Mehra, Baba was not allowing Mehra to touch the male doctor. But Baba told to Mehra, just, you know, Baba sent the message, let the doctor, what he is giving the treatment, allow him to give them the treatment. And then Mehra she accepted that. About 12 days, you know, Baba stayed there. William Dorkin also came. Then Ivy Dosh, her daughter Salman, and all these Mandli members, where they went to the Mehr Mount. They came from Mehr Mount also. And then all they started, you know, looking after Baba. The night watch and that everything. And about 12 days Baba he stayed there. And then after 12 days, you know, they arranged, you know, for Baba to go back to the Muttal Beach along with the Mandli members. And then they just hired the ambulance, paid about $800 in that time. You know, it was a really big amount, $800, and then two ambulance and a car was arranged. And then it took 4 to 5 days, you know, for them to reach to the Muttal Beach. It was 1500 miles, means about 3000 kilometers, yes, more than 3000 kilometers. And in that condition, Baba's one leg was in plaster and other hand also fractured. And in that condition, you know, Mehra's condition was also not that much good. But they traveled from Prague to the Muttal Beach. And then Baba just stayed there in the Muttal Beach. And then according to his timetable, what they fixed to travel the different places, you know. And after that also, Baba, he went to the London, Switzerland and other places. And then from there, he came to the Karachi. And from Karachi, Baba returned back to the Mehrazad. All this the timetable, what was fixed for Baba, Baba, he attended everything very proper way. Only Mehr Mount, he did not go, he did not attend that time the Mehr Mount, but other places, all Baba, he attended. And that time Baba said, you know, just, you know, America, I shed my blood in America. That was my will, and according to my will, it happened. And now just the result, it will come really the benefit for the whole universe, you know. That is the good result. For that purpose, you know, just I said, I split my blood in the soil of America. And that was really the different work of the God-man. Baba was attending the fiery life, and it was up to 10th July that fiery life was there. And in that fiery life, this incident took place. And two places the incident took place. One was in India, 1956, and second is in 52 in America. And God, he does all this for his universal work. And according to that, you know, everything happened according to the universal work. All the Mandli members also who were with Baba, they also came along with Baba. Some they came before Baba came, arrived to the Karachi, but others, ladies, Mandlis and that, and they came along with Baba. And then Baba came from Bombay to Mehrazad. And this is the incident of Baba's accident taken place. Baki Jai.
అవతార్ మెహేర్ బాబా కీ జై. 24 మే 1952 బాబావారి మొదటి కారు ప్రమాదం గురించి తెలుసుకుందాం. బాబా ఇలా అన్నారు, అవతారుడు భూమి మీద అడుగుపెట్టేది కేవలం బాధలు అనుభవించడానికే. కనుక బాధలు అనుభవించడానికి ఎన్ని మార్గాలున్నాయో వాటన్నిటి ద్వారా కూడా ఆయన బాధలు అనుభవిస్తూనే ఉంటాడు. అలా బాధ అనుభవించడం ద్వారానే విశ్వభారాన్ని తన భుజాల మీద ఎత్తుకుంటాడు ఆయన. ప్రతి అవతారంలో కూడా ఇలాగే జరుగుతుంది సుమా అన్నారు బాబా. ఆయన అవతార ఉద్యమం అంటే ఏమిటో బాబా ఇలా చెప్పారు, తన శరీరాన్ని వీలైనంత బాధలకు గురిచేసి తద్వారా విశ్వభారాన్ని తన మీద వేసుకొని మానవాళికి విమోచనం కలిగించడమే, ఇదే అవతార ఉద్యమం అంటారు. చిట్ట చివరికి తన శరీరాన్ని కూడా ఈ విశ్వానికి బలిచ్చేసి వెళ్ళిపోతాడైన, ఇది బాబా చెప్పారు. మెహర్ బాబా వారి అవతార జీవితంలో 2 కారు ప్రమాదాల ద్వారా తన శరీరాన్ని మొక్కలు చేసుకున్నారు బాబా. మొదటి ప్రమాదం 24/5/52 అమెరికా దేశంలో గల ప్రేగ్ అనే నగరానికి దగ్గరలో జరిగింది. రెండవది 2 డిసెంబర్ 1956 నాడు మన దేశంలోని మహారాష్ట్రంలో ఉన్న సతారా నగరానికి దగ్గరలో ఉడతారా అనే గ్రామం దగ్గరే జరిగింది. మొదటి ప్రమాదంలో బాబాతో పాటు స్త్రీ మండలి వారు గాయపడ్డారు. రెండవ ప్రమాదంలో బాబాతో పాటు పురుష మండలి వారు గాయపడ్డారు. చూసారా ఎలాగా ఇద్దరికీ సమానంగా అందులో వాటా ఇచ్చారు బాబా. మే నెల అనగానే బాబా ప్రేమికులందరికీ ఆ బాబావారి కారు ప్రమాదం గుర్తుకొస్తుంది. కనుక ఆ మొదటి కారు ప్రమాదం గురించి ఒక్కసారి జ్ఞాపకం చేసుకుందాం. అమెరికా దేశానికి బయలుదేరే ముందే ఈ ప్రమాదం గురించి బాబా సూచన చేస్తూనే ఉన్నారు. అమెరికా నా రక్తాన్ని కోరుతోంది సుమా అని ముందుగానే చెప్పారు, కానీ ఎవ్వరూ గ్రహించలేకపోయారు. నిజానికి ఈ ప్రమాదం గురించి చాలా సంవత్సరాల క్రితమే బాబా సూచించి ఉన్నారు. ఉదాహరణకు ఈ ప్రమాదం 1952 జరిగితే 1932 పాశ్చాత్య దేశాలకు వెళ్ళినప్పుడే ఎలిజబెత్ ప్యాటర్సన్ అనే ప్రేమికురాలని పిలిచి ఆ ప్రక్కనే ఉన్న ఒక చెట్టు నుంచి ఒక పువ్వును కోసి ఆవిడ చేతిలో పెట్టారు. ఈ రోజును గుర్తించుకోసుమా, ఈ పువ్వును కూడా జాగ్రత్తగా దాచిపెట్టు సుమా, తర్వాత దీని అర్థం ఏంటో నీకు తెలుస్తుందిలే అని చెప్పారు. ఆవిడ బాబా చెప్పినట్టే దానికి ఒక పుస్తకం మధ్యలో పెట్టి ఆ డేట్ రాసుకుంది. ఆవిడ కారు ప్రమాదం జరిగిపోయిన తర్వాత ఆమె తన డైరీని చూసి ఆశ్చర్యపోయింది. ఖచ్చితంగా 20 సంవత్సరాల క్రితం బాబా అంటే 24 మే 1932 నాడే ఆ పువ్వు ఇచ్చారు. అంటే ఈ ప్రమాదం గురించి అప్పుడే సూచన చేశారన్నమాట బాబా. అయితే ప్రమాదం జరిగిపోయిన తర్వాత బాబా ఇలా చెప్పారు, ఈ ప్రమాదం యొక్క ఫలితం మొత్తం ప్రపంచాన్ని అంతటికీ ప్రయోజనం చేకూరుస్తుంది సుమా. అసలు ఈ ప్రమాదం వెనుక ఉన్నటువంటి అసలు కారణం నేను చెప్తానని ఒక సందర్భంలో బాబా ఇలా చెప్పారు, పశ్చిమ దేశాల శాస్త్ర విజ్ఞానాన్ని తూర్పు దేశాల వారికి, తూర్పు దేశాల ఆధ్యాత్మిక సంపదను పశ్చిమ దేశాల వారికి బదిలీ చేయడం కోసమే ఈ యాక్సిడెంట్ చేసుకున్నాను నేను అన్నారు బాబా. బాబా స్త్రీ మండలితో కలిసి కారులో అమెరికా దేశం యొక్క తూర్పు ప్రాంతం నుండి పశ్చిమ ప్రాంతానికి వెళుతూ ఉండగా ఈ కారుకు ప్రమాదం జరిగింది. బాబా మరియు మెహరా ఈ కారులోంచి బయటికి ఇసిరేపడ్డారన్నమాట ఆ యాక్సిడెంట్ యొక్క కుదుపుకి. బాబా యొక్క ఎడమ భాగం అంతా విరిగిపోయింది. ఆయన ఎడమ కాలు, ఎడమ చెయ్యి, ముక్కుకున్న దూలం, నాలిక అడ్డుగా తెగిపోయింది. మెహరాకైతే నుదుటి మీద తీవ్రమైన గాయం కూడా అయ్యింది. కాసేపటి తర్వాత సరోష్ కారు వచ్చి అక్కడ ఆగింది. యాంబులెన్స్ పిలిపించారు. ఆ యాంబులెన్స్ రాగానే మెహరు గబగబా బాబా చెవిలో ఇలా అంది, బాబా మరి మెహరాని పురుషులు తాకకూడదు అని ఆంక్ష పెట్టారు కదా మీరు, కానీ యాంబులెన్స్లో ఉన్న సహాయకులందరూ మగవాళ్ళే, మరి ఎలా అని అడిగింది. ఒకంత బాబా సంతోషపడ్డారు. అంటే అటువంటి పరిస్థితుల్లో కూడా తన ఆజ్ఞను గుర్తుపెట్టుకున్నటువంటి గొప్పవాళ్ళు మండలి వాళ్ళు. బాబా అన్నారు, ఏం పర్వాలేదులే, ఏం జరిగినా నేను బాధ్యత వహిస్తానులే అని బాబా చెప్పారు. తర్వాత ప్రేగ్ అనే ఆ దగ్గరలో ఉన్నటువంటి ఆ పట్టణంలో ఒక ప్రైవేట్ ఆసుపత్రిలో బాబాకు మెహరాకు చికిత్స జరిగింది. అన్ని గాయాలు నయం అయిన తర్వాతే తనకు ఎంత తీవ్రమైన గాయాలయ్యాయో మెహ్రాకు తెలియజేయమన్నారు బాబా. అప్పుడు దాకా దాచేశారు. ఎందుకని, ఆవిడికే బోల్డ్ గాయమైంది, మరి ఇది కూడా తెలిస్తే ఆవిడ తట్టుకోలేదేమో. బాబాకు బాల్యం నుండి కూడా ఒక అలవాటు ఉండేదట, ఆయన బాల్య స్నేహితుడైన బేలీ చెప్పాడు, తనకి ఏ కష్టం వచ్చినా ఎవరికి చెప్పేవాడు కాదట. అది చిట్ట చివరి వరకు కొనసాగింది బాబాకు ఆ అలవాటు. అంచేటప్పుడు కూడా మెహరాన్ చూసిరండి, మెహరాన్ చూసిరండి అనేవారు వీళ్ళు. వీళ్ళంతా అనుకునేవారు బాబాకి ఏం తగలలేదేమో అనుకునేవారు. ఆ బెడ్షీట్ తీస్తే ఈ దెబ్బలన్నీ బ్యాండేజ్లు చూసి ఆశ్చర్యపోయేవారు. సరే, అంత కోలుకున్న తర్వాత మెహరాను అనునయిస్తూ బాబా ఇలా చెప్పారు, నా విశ్వకార్యం కోసం నీ నుదుటి మీద ఒక గాయం అవసరమైంది, అంచేతే నేను ఇచ్చాను సుమా అన్నారు. వెంటనే మెహ్రా బాబాని ఆలింగనం చేసుకుని, బాబా ఆ గాయాన్ని నాకిచ్చి ఎంత మంచి పని చేశావో, నీ అందమైన ముఖం మీదే కనుక ఈ మచ్చ ఉండుంటే నీ ప్రేమికులంతా ప్రపంచవ్యాప్తంగా ఎంత నొచ్చుకుని ఉండేవారు కదా అంది. చూసారా ఎంత ఆ గొప్ప ప్రేమ ఆ మెహ్రాది. ఈ విధంగా ఆయన చేసిన అపారమైన త్యాగానికి, మనం ఆయనకు కృతజ్ఞత చెప్పుకోవడానికి 24 మే ఒక అపురూపమైనటువంటి అవకాశం. ఇదంతా ఆయన ప్రేమిక ప్రపంచానికి ఒక వరంగా బాబా ఇచ్చారు. దాన్ని మనందరం సద్వినియోగం చేసుకుందాం. అవతార్ మెహేర్ బాబాకి జై.
Thank you.
Pavadigar, the preserver and protector of all. You are without beginning and without end, none dual beyond comparison, and none can measure you. You are without color, without expression, without form, and without attributes. You are unlimited and unfathomable, beyond imagination and conception, eternal and imperishable. You are indivisible, and none can see you but with eyes divine. You always were, you always are, and you always will be. You are everywhere, you are in everything, and you are also beyond everywhere and beyond everything. You are in the firmament and in the depths. You are manifest and unmanifest, on all planes and beyond all planes. You are in the three worlds and also beyond the three worlds. You are imperceptible and independent. You are the Creator, the Lord of Lords, the knower of all minds and hearts. You are omnipotent and omnipresent. You are knowledge, infinite, power, infinite, and bliss, infinite. You are the ocean of knowledge, all-knowing, infinitely knowing, the knower of the past, the present, and the future. And you are knowledge itself. You are all-merciful and eternally benevolent. You are the soul of souls, the one with infinite attributes. You are the trinity of truth, knowledge, and bliss. You are the source of truth, the ocean of love. You are the Ancient One, the Highest of the High. You are Prabhu and Parmeshwar. You are the Beyond God and the Beyond Beyond God also. You are Parabrahma, Allah, Elohi, Yazdan, Ahura Mazda, and God the Beloved. You are named Izzad, the only one worthy of worship, Mihir Baba. We repent, O God, most merciful, for all our sins, for every thought that was false or unjust or unclean, for every word spoken that ought not to have been spoken, for every deed done that ought not to have been done. We repent for every deed and word and thought inspired by selfishness, and for every deed and word and thought inspired by hatred. We repent most specially for every lustful thought and every lustful action, for every lie, for all hypocrisy, for every promise given but not fulfilled, and for all slander and backbiting. Most especially also we repent for every action that has brought ruin to others, for every word and deed that has given others pain, and for every wish that pain should befall others. In your unbounded mercy, we ask you to forgive us, O God, for all these sins committed by us, and to forgive us for our constant failures to think and speak and act according to your will. Amen. Beloved God, help us all to love you more and more and more and more and still yet more till we become worthy of union with you. And help us all to hold fast to Baba's Dhamman till the very end. Avatar Mir Baba Ki Jai.
The lover has to keep the wish of the beloved. My wish for my lovers is as follows. Do not shirk your responsibilities. Attend faithfully to your worldly duties, but keep always at the back of your mind that all this is Baba's. When you feel happy, think Baba wants me to be happy. When you suffer, think Baba wants me to suffer. Be resigned to every situation and think honestly and sincerely, Baba has placed me in this situation. With the understanding that Baba is in everyone, try to help and serve others. I say with my divine authority to each and all that whosoever takes my name at the time of breathing his last comes to me, so do not forget to remember me in your last moments. Unless you start remembering me from now on, it will be difficult to remember me when your end approaches. You should start practicing from now on, even if you take my name only once every day. You will not forget to remember me in your dying moments.